Alright, it's time for a showdown. The Battle of the 2-in-1s. Microsoft Surface Pro 8 versus Surface Go 3. Let's go over the raw stats. Starting off, we've got two 2-in-1 laptops, one acting more as a primary computer and the other acting more as a secondary or complement to your setup. Either way, we've got wild price differences, and this is supposed to be a fairly unfair matchup, but given these big price differences, let's see how well they compare. Starting off, let's give the Surface Pro 8 a second to flex because it has a larger screen and resolution well beyond 1080p. While on the other end, the Surface Go 3 is smaller with a not as high resolution, but what can you expect with a massive price difference? So yeah, the Surface Pro 8 definitely gets this victory. Of course, this victory is short-lived because of the next section, connectivity. And that's not great. Can't even choose a better option in this case because they both have trade-offs. Strangely though, the Surface Go has a microSD card slot, while the so-called professional Surface Pro does not. It does, however, have an extra USB port, so you can decide the winner of that on your own. But for internal specs, of course the winner is going to be the more expensive option. I mean, come on, here are the benchmarks. For storage, they're both disappointing, and yes, the Surface Pro does come with a little bit more storage than the Surface Go, but price per gigabyte, the Surface Go is actually cheaper than the Surface Pro. So, it might not be faster storage, but you do get more for your dollar. And lastly, both of them run Windows 11. And to end this matchup, we've got a tie. Let's go on to my suggestion. As always with these topics, I try not to make too many conclusions for you, only adding a few quirks here and there to try to keep your attention, while also letting you know what you're buying into. So as always, as usual, the best option is based on your needs. Like I said, these are two wildly different laptops. The Surface Pro 8 is a primary computer, so you should buy it if you want to use it as a main portable workstation. It works great for that. You can travel, take notes because it's also a tablet, and use it as a typical computer. It's multifaceted, and it could be very useful for you. However, the price could be a major deterrent, in which case, you might want to take a look at the Surface Go 3. Now to preface, the Surface Go 3 will not run well in everything, dare I say many things, because it's cheap, not cheaply made, but it's not made to be expensive. The Surface Go 3 is a tablet-y laptop as well, so you can take notes on it and have the same portability and general use as a laptop. It's also smaller than the Pro, so it might even be more portable and usable in, let's say, an airplane. But it's not a workstation, so it probably can't do everything you need. So my suggestion is, if you don't have another computer, get the Surface Pro 8. It'll cover all of your needs and help you complete your work with excellent performance. However, if you do already have a computer for work and you want to supplement some of it with another device, get the Surface Go 3. It's a great addition to your setup and will definitely aid in productivity. But ultimately, all of this is your decision based on your preferences. Don't just watch my video on this. I've linked many more down in the description to view at your discretion. My name is Cyrus. It's spelled like Cyrus, pronounced like Seerooster. Just take out the tur. Thank you very much for watching. Good luck with your purchase and have a wonderful day.